Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Gaurav Kumar Jain from Jamia Hamdard University, New Delhi. Today, in this module, we will discuss polymers as excipients for novel drug delivery applications, part 2, under paper product development, part 1. The learning objectives of this module are, first of all, we will study about smart polymers and how they work. Second, we will discuss about stimuli-responsive polymers and their application in drug delivery. Third, we will discuss about bioresponsive polymers and their applications in drug delivery. Fourth, we will discuss about mechanisms of mucoadhesion, factors affecting mucoadhesion, mucoadhesive polymers and their application in drug delivery. To start with introduction of smart polymers, we will first discuss their use. To start with introduction, with the emergence of novel and effective drugs, increased importance is being placed upon the ways by which these drugs are being delivered to the body. Conventional drug delivery methods result in a peak in plasma drug concentrations, followed by a plateau and finally a decline. As a result, these methods of drug delivery may lead to toxic plasma drug concentrations or ineffective plasma levels. Even though sustained and controlled release devices are advantageous, since they maintain the drug within the desired therapeutic range with just a single dose, they also reduce dose frequency, they allow localized drug delivery, they prevent degradation of drug by the body, and ultimately improve patient compliance, but they remain insensitive to the challenging metabolic states of the body. Mechanisms capable of responding to these physiological variations must be provided in order to synchronize drug release profiles with changing physiological conditions. Ideally, a drug delivery system should respond to physiological requirements, sense the change, and alter the drug release profile accordingly. Similar to living systems that can non-linearly respond to external applied stimuli or signals, polymers can undergo drastic changes in chemical or physical properties to adapt to the surrounding environment, which made them unique materials for wide applications including drug delivery, imaging, theranostic, and tissue engineering. Such polymers are called as smart polymers, stimuli-responsive polymers, environmental-sensitive polymers, or intelligent polymers. The distinguishing characteristic of these stimuli-responsive polymers is their ability to undergo rapid changes in their microstructure from a hydrophilic to a hydrophobic state in response to an external stimuli. The macroscopic changes that occur are reversible, therefore the system is capable of returning to its initial state when the stimulus is removed. Common stimuli that drive these changes are temperature, pH, light, electric field, and various biological responses. Responses to these stimuli may be manifested as changes in shape, surface characteristics, solubility, hydrophilic hydrophobic balance, formation of an intricate molecular assembly, or salt to gel transition. Based on these changes, the polymers are classified into three categories. Number one, linear polymer that undergo coil to globule transition in solution. Polymers under this category undergoes a reversible collapse upon the application of an external stimulus. For phase transition to occur, a delicate balance between hydrophilic and hydrophobic proportion is required in the molecular structure of the polymer. With increasing hydrophobicity, the soluble polymer is precipitated out of solution and forms a totally different insoluble phase. This conversion is achieved either due to neutralization of the electric charges that are present on the polymeric network or because of reduction in the number of hydrogen bonds that the polymer forms with water. The second type of polymers are covalently cross-linked hydrogels that undergo swelling or deswelling. Investigations into stimuli-responsive polymers have often been focused to a large extent on hydrogels that swell in aqueous media. These hydrogels may respond rapidly to physical and chemical stimuli, resulting in changes in swelling behavior due to change in polymer-polymer or water-polymer interactions. These hydrogels may be synthesized in the conventional manner to result in hydrogels with small pore size, or they may be synthesized by various other approaches to result in macroporous hydrogels for different applications. The third type of polymers are amphiphilic block copolymers, which undergo self-assembly or micellization. Phase separation of stimuli-responsive polymers occurs only when a sharp conformational change of a macromolecule occurs. This change must be accompanied with a drastic increase in hydrophobicity triggered by a small change in the environment. When a polymer reversibly swells or collapses on a surface, it converts the interface from hydrophilic to hydrophobic and vice versa. This occurs when the collapsed hydrophobic macromolecules aggregate and forms a separate phase. The intelligent polymers do not aggregate, but the conformational transition from a hydrophilic to a hydrophobic state renders the surface hydrophobic. The surface is hydrophilic when the polymer is in expanded soluble state and hydrophobic when it is in collapsed insoluble state. Now we will discuss the critical attributes required for a smart polymer in order to deliver the drug. The smart polymer should be biocompatible and biodegradable. It should sustain or control the release of drug. It should have high drug loading capacity, lack detrimental properties such as toxicity, immunogenicity, and carcinogenicity. It should have ability to undergo modification with ease and should have excellent stability profile. The major benefits of using a smart polymer-based drug delivery system includes: the drug could be released at the target site in the desired manner. They should maintain desired therapeutic concentration of the drug. They should prolong release of incorporated drug. It results in reduced dosing frequency, reduced side effects, and ultimately patient compliance. The first type of smart polymers which we are going to discuss is temperature responsive polymers. Temperature has been widely investigated as a stimulant for responsive polymer systems owing to its ease of modulation and applicability in drug delivery applications. Temperature sensitive polymers, called as thermosensitive polymers, undergo abrupt change in their structure and solubility in response to a small change in temperature. Thermosensitive polymers are characterized by presence of lower critical solution temperature, called as LCST, or upper critical solution temperature, called as UCST. Lower critical solution temperature is the temperature above which the polymeric monophasic systems becomes hydrophobic and insoluble, leading to phase separation, whereas below the LCST, the polymers are soluble. This phase transition stems from hydrophilic-hydrophobic balance of polymer chain, which is modulated by recurrent establishment and disruption of intra- and intermolecular electrostatic and hydrophobic interactions. Below the LCST, water molecules exist in an ordered state in the local environment of polymer chains. As temperature rises above the LCST, polymer-polymer hydrophobic interactions dominate, polymer chains collapse, and water molecules are released to the bulk, resulting in a net entropic gain from the polymer solvent system. As for example, NIPAM has been thoroughly investigated for its ability to undergo a reversible negative temperature dependent phase transition. Below its LCST, which is 32 degrees Celsius, NIPAM exists as a hydrophilic coil, whereas above LCST, NIPAM chain collapses sharply into a hydrophobic globule. In contrast to this, polymers that exhibit positive temperature dependent swelling behavior, that is, a globule to coil transition with increasing temperature, possesses and UCST. For pharmaceutical applications, LCST systems are preferred over UCST systems because high temperatures for UCST systems are unfavorable for heat labile drugs and biomolecules. An aqueous thermosensitive polymeric solution exhibits temperature dependent and reversible salt to gel transitions near body temperature that control the rate of release of incorporated drug along with maintaining physicochemical stability and biological activity. This phenomena is generally governed by the ratio of hydrophilic to lipophilic moieties on the polymer chain and is an energy-driven phenomena which depends on the free energy of mixing or the enthalpy or entropy of the system. For drug delivery applications, it may be desirable to shift the critical temperature for volume phase transition to a specific temperature range. This can be accomplished through the inclusion of hydrophilic or hydrophobic moieties in the polymer chain. Usually, polymers with larger hydrophobic hydration area possess stronger hydrophobic interactive forces and undergo collapse at a lower temperature. Conversely, increasing the hydrophilic content of the polymer chain will increase the LCST. LCST temperature of NIPAM, that is 32 degrees Celsius, can be shifted to body temperature by formulating with surfactants or additives. This makes NIPAM an excellent carrier for in situ drug delivery. Thermoresponsive polymers are attractive candidates for in situ implants in which thermoreversible gelation is exploited for the facile implantation of solid drug depot preparations. In these systems, a liquid drug polymer solution is injected into a target site at ambient temperature. As the solution temperature warms to body temperature, the polymer gels, which entraps the drug in the physically cross-linked matrix. Diffusion of the drug from the solid gel allows for sustained release formulations. In a reported study using temperature-responsive chitosan grafted with PEG, delivery of protein bovine serum albumin was sustained for approximately 70 hours. Further, cross-linking of gel with genipin results in prolongation of release of bovine serum albumin for up to 40 days. Thermoresponsive polymers also play a role in targeting drugs to inflammatory sites and cancerous cells since these sites have slightly higher temperature compared to rest of body. The thermosensitive polymers can be categorized into four types. Number one, polymers exhibiting phase transition at LCST such as NIPAM, poly-N-vinyl caprolactam, polyvinyl methyl ether, polydimethyl aminoethyl methacrylate, poly-N-vinyl isobutyl amide, and pluronics. Second, amphiphilic block polymers such as polyoxyethylene and polyoxypropylene. Third, thermosensitive polysaccharides including cellulose derivatives like ethyl cellulose, ethyl hydroxyethyl cellulose, hydroxyethyl cellulose, and certain natural polysaccharides such as agarose, carrageenan, amylose, amylopectin, and galangum. Number four, artificial polypeptides comprising of elastin-like polymers or silk-like block copolymers. The major advantage of thermosensitive polymeric system is the avoidance of toxic organic solvents, their ability to deliver both hydrophilic and lipophilic drugs, the reduced systemic side effects of drug, site-specific drug delivery, and sustained release properties. The next category to discuss is pH-responsive polymers. Physiological pH varies systemically in the body, particularly along the GI tract, where stomach has a pH of 1 to 3, followed by duodenum with pH value of 5 to 6, followed by small intestine with pH ranging from 6.2 to 7 and colon with pH ranging from 7 to 7.5. Physiological pH also change among cellular compartments with endosomes, lysosomes and Golgi complex exhibiting pH values in range of 5 to 6.8, 4.5 to 5.5 and 6.2 to 6.4 respectively. Also, it is well known that the inflamed or diseased tissues exhibit different pH than normal tissues. Tumors have been reported to produce acidic conditions leading to pH 6.5 in the extracellular milieu. Thus, it is no surprise that scientists and engineers have devoted considerable effort towards the rational design of polymers capable of exploiting these pH variations to selectively deliver valuable therapeutics to specific intracellular or extracellular sites of action. By judicious material selection and careful engineering of molecular architecture, pH-responsive polymer delivery systems can be developed to give well-controlled pH response and drug release. All pH-sensitive polymers consist of pendant acidic or basic groups that can either accept or release a proton in response to changes in environmental pH. pH-sensitive polymers are classified into two types, weak polyacids and weak polybases. First, we discuss about weak polyacids. Weak polyacids accept protons at low pH and release protons at neutral and high pH. As the environmental pH changes, the pendant acidic group undergoes ionization at a specific pH. This rapid change in net charge of the attached group causes alteration in the molecular structure of the polymeric chain. This transition to expanded state is mediated by the osmotic pressure exerted by mobile counter ions neutralized by network charges. Polyacrylic acid and polymethacrylic acid are commonly used pH-responsive polyacids. The carboxyl group of polyacrylic acid and polymethacrylic acid remains in the unionized state in the acidic pH environment of stomach and get ionized in the alkaline environment of small intestine, releasing the drug molecule. pH-sensitive polymers containing a sulfonamide group are another example of polyacid polymers in which the hydrogen atom of the amide nitrogen is readily ionized to form polyacids. The second category is weak polybases. Polybases bearing an attached amino group are the most representative polybasic group. Polycationic polymers such as chitosan, polylysine, poly-NN-dimethylaminoethylmethacrylate, polyvinylamine, poly-NN-dialkylaminoethylmethacrylate, and polyethylenamine exhibit a different behavior in different pH environment. The amine groups of these polycationic polymers exist in the unionized form. In neutral or alkaline pH, they keep the drug intact in the carrier structure, and when the pH value is reduced to less than the pKa, they become ionized, leading to swelling of polymer due to electrostatic repulsion of the neighboring positively charged group and thereby releasing the drug to the environment. Next to discuss are light-sensitive polymers. A light-sensitive polymer undergoes a phase transition in response to exposure to light. The major advantages of light-sensitive polymers are that they are water-soluble, biocompatible, biodegradable, and had capacity for instantaneous transition from salt to gel, making light-sensitive polymers important for various engineering and biomedical applications. Light-responsive polymers are very attractive for triggering drug release because of the ability to control the spatial and temporal triggering of the release. This means that the encapsulated drug can be released or active after irradiation with a light source from outside the body. The light-sensitive polymers can be classified on the basis of wavelength of light that triggers the phase transition as, first, UV light-sensitive polymers, second, visible light-sensitive polymers, and third, infrared light-sensitive polymers. First to discuss is UV light-sensitive polymers. Polymer gels containing a leucoderivative molecule, bis-4-dimethylamino phenylmethyl leucocyanide, undergoes phase transition behavior in response to UV light. Triphenylmethane leucoderivative dissociate into ion pairs such as triphenylmethyl cation upon UV irradiation. At a fixed temperature, these hydrogels swells discontinuously due to increased osmotic pressure in response to UV irradiation, but shrink when the stimulus is removed. Increased osmotic pressure within the gel was due to cyanide ion formed by UV irradiation. The second type of polymers are visible light-sensitive polymers. Visible light-sensitive hydrogels are prepared by incorporating photosensitive molecules or chromophores such as trisodium salt of copper chlorophyllene to thermosensitive polymer. When light of appropriate wavelength is applied, the chromophore absorbs light, which is then dissipated locally as heat, increasing the temperature of the hydrogel, leading to alteration of the swelling behavior of the thermosensitive hydrogel. The temperature increase directly depends on the intensity of light and chromophore concentration. Another example of visible light-responsive hydrogel for temporal drug delivery is cross-linked hyaluronic acid hydrogel that undergoes photosensitized degradation in the presence of methylene blue. Visible light-sensitive polymers are comparatively preferred over UV light-sensitive polymers because of their higher safety and ease of use. The third category is infrared light-sensitive polymers. Another activation mechanism is the use of infrared light, which can elicit a response in hydrogels in the absence of chromophores. The method is advantageous since water readily absorbs infrared radiations. When hydrogels without chromophores are irradiated by infrared, the volume phase transition along with gel bending was observed. The relaxation of the gel to its original form takes place after irradiation was terminated. The limitations of light-sensitive polymers include inconsistent response due to the leaching of non-covalently bound chromophores during swelling or contraction of the system, also a slow response of hydrogel towards the stimulus is a problem. Dark toxicity is also one of the drawbacks of light-responsive polymeric systems. Next type of responsive polymers to discuss are electric field-sensitive polymers. Electric field-sensitive polymers change their physical properties in response to a small change in electric current. Most polymers that exhibit electrosensitive behavior are polyelectrolytes, that is, they contain a relative high number of ionizable groups and they are pH responsive as well. These polyelectrolytes undergo deformation under an electric field due to anisotropic swelling or deswelling as the charge ions move towards the cathode or anode. Greatest stress is felt by the region surrounding the anode and a smaller stress near the vicinity of the cathode. This stress gradient contributes to the anisotropic gel deformation under an electric field. Electroresponsive polymers transform electric energy into mechanical energy and had shown wide application in the field of sustained and targeted drug delivery. The electric current causes a change in pH, which leads to disruption of hydrogen bonding between polymer chains, causing bending or degradation of the polymer chain, leading to drug release. The mechanisms involved in drug release are electrophoresis of charged drug, diffusion, force convection of drug out of the gel and liberation of drug upon erosion of electro-erodible polymers. Gel bending or degradation due to electric field stimulus depends on number of factors such as position of gel relative to the electrodes, applied voltage, osmotic pressure, and thickness or shape of the gel. Naturally occurring polymers such as chitosan, alginate, and hyaluronic acid are commonly employed to prepare electro-responsive materials. Synthetic polymers such as vinyl alcohol, acrylonitrile, allyl amine, methacrylic acid, and vinyl acrylic acid are also commonly used. Combination of natural and synthetic polymers are also employed for development of electro-responsive drug delivery systems. One of the application of electrosensitive polymers includes the delivery of hydrophobium hydrochloride and hydrocortisone in a pulsatile manner using the polymer poly-2-acrylamido-2-methylpropane sulfonic acid co-N-butyl-methacrylate. Control of drug release was achieved by varying the intensity of electric stimulation. The major constraint that has to be considered in developing this type of drug delivery system is the critical selection of electric current which can cause drug release without stimulating the nerve endings in the surrounding tissue. Next to discuss are bioresponsive polymers. Biologically responsive polymer systems are increasingly important in various biomedical applications. The major advantage of bioresponsive polymers is that they can respond to the stimuli that are inherently present in the natural system. Bioresponsive polymeric systems mainly arise from common functional groups that are known to interact with biologically relevant species, and in other instances, the synthetic polymer is conjugated to a biological component. The working of biological responsive polymer is shown by taking example of glucose responsive polymers. Glucose responsive polymers have the ability to mimic normal endogenous insulin secretion, which minimizes diabetic complications and can release the bioactive compound in a controlled manner. These are sugar sensitive and show variability in response to the presence of glucose. These polymers have garnered considerable attention because of their application in both glucose sensing and insulin delivery. Type 1 systems are those which work on the principle of enzymatic oxidation of glucose by glucose oxidase. This delivery system consists of insulin entrapped in polyacrylic acid polymer conjugated with the glucose oxidase system. Glucose sensitivity occurs by the response of the polymer towards the byproducts that results from the enzymatic oxidation of glucose. Glucose oxidase oxidizes glucose, resulting in the formation of gluconic acid and hydrogen peroxide. As the blood glucose level is increased, glucose is converted into gluconic acid, which causes the reduction of pH and protonation of polyacrylic acid carboxylate moieties. The protonation of polyacrylic acid polymer causes the release of insulin due to polymer swelling. Type 2 system works on the principle of specific binding of lactin with glucose. This system utilizes the unique carbohydrate binding properties of lactin for the fabrication of a glucose-sensitive system. Concanavalin A is a lactin possessing 4 binding sites and has been used frequently in insulin-modulated drug delivery. In this type of system, the insulin moiety is chemically modified by introducing a functional group and then attached to a carrier or support through specific interactions which can only be interrupted by the glucose itself. The glycosylated insulin concanavalin A complex exploits the competitive binding behavior of concanavalin A with glucose and glycosylated insulin. The free glucose molecule causes the displacement of glycosylated concanavalin A insulin conjugates within the surrounding tissue and are bioactive. Type 3 systems are based on reversible covalent bond formation by phenyl boronic acid moieties. Polymers with phenyl boronic group form gel with molecules such as diglucosyl hexadiamine due to complex formation between the pendant phenyl borate and hydroxyl groups. As the glucose concentration increases, the cross-linking density of the gel decreases, and as a result, insulin is released from the eroded gel. The glucose exchange reaction is reversible and reformation of the gel occurs as a result of borate polyol cross-linking. In spite of many advantages, the major limitations of these systems are their short response time and possible non-compatibility. Next category of smart polymers are bioadhesive or mucoadhesive polymers. Bioadhesion is defined as a phenomena of interfacial molecular attractive forces among the surfaces of the biological membrane and the polymers, which allows the polymer to adhere to the biological surface for an extended period of time. Mucoadhesion specifically represents adhesion of the polymers with the surface of the mucosal layer made up of mucus secreted by the goblet cells. It lines the visceral organs which are exposed to the external environment. The main components of mucus are water and mucin and anionic polyelectrolyte with minor quantities of proteins, lipids and mucopolysaccharides. The adhesion of delivery system to mucus has been explored for improved retention of the bioactive agent at the desired location, thus improving bioavailability. The use of specific bioadhesive molecules allow for possible targeting of particular sites or tissue, for example, the ocular surface or GI tract. Sustained drug release combined with increased residence time, which may lead to lower administration frequency, avoidance of first-pass metabolism, and ultimately reduction of dose-related side effects due to drug localization at the disease site. Polymers used in mucosal delivery system may be of natural or synthetic origin. In this section, we will briefly discuss theory of mucoadhesions, factors affecting mucoadhesion, and some of the common classes of mucoadhesive polymers. The phenomena of mucoadhesion can be explained by various theories. The first one is electronic theory. According to this theory, transfer of electrons among the surface of the polymer and mucosa results in formation of an electric double layer, thereby giving rise to attractive forces. The second one is wetting theory. According to this theory, mucoadhesion develops between polymer and the mucosal surface if the polymer in liquid system is in intimate contact with mucosal surface and if it sufficiently spreads over the surface of mucosa. The third theory is adsorption theory. According to this theory, the mucoadhesion develops between polymer and the mucosal surface owing to presence of intermolecular forces like hydrogen bonding and van der Waal forces. The next theory of mucoadhesion is diffusion theory. This theory assumes that the polymer chains present on the polymer undergoes diffusion across the mucosal surface, forming a networked structure and thus mucoadhesion. The next theory is mechanical theory. According to this theory, mucoadhesion develops due to diffusion of the liquid adhesives into the microcracks and irregularities present on the substrate surface, thereby forming an interlocked structure. The last theory of mucoadhesion is cohesive theory, according to which the phenomena of bioadhesion are mainly due to the intermolecular interactions among the like molecules. The mucoadhesive property of a polymer can be tailored by changing the parameters which alter the interaction among the polymer and the mucosal layer. In this section, we will study the parameters which can tailor the mucoadhesive property of the polymers. The first parameter is molecular weight. Generally, the interpenetration of polymer molecule is favored by low molecular weight polymers, whereas entanglements are favored by high molecular weight polymers. Thus, mucoadhesiveness of a polymer increases with the increase in molecular weight of the polymer chain. Polymers with molecular weight greater than 100 kilodalton possess adequate mucoadhesive property. As for example, PEG of 20 kilodalton molecular weight does not exhibit mucoadhesion, whereas PEG of 200 kilodalton exhibit mucoadhesion and PEG of 400 kilodalton exhibit excellent mucoadhesive properties. Similarly, polyacrylic acid of around 750 kilodaltons, polyethylene oxides of around 4000 kilodaltons, and dextrins of around 19,500 kilodaltons showed good mucoadhesive properties. The second parameter is polymer chain. It is generally accepted that increase in polymer chain length increases the mucoadhesive property of the polymer. Not only chain length, but also flexibility of polymer chain plays important role in mucoadhesion. Flexible polymeric chains helps in the better entanglement to the mucosal layer. Thus, tethering of long flexible chains onto the polymer matrices is an excellent way to improve their mucoadhesive property. This phenomena has been utilized to develop tethered PEG polyacrylic acid hydrogels with improved mucoadhesive properties. The flexibility of the polymer chains is affected by hydration of the polymer network and the cross-linking. The lower the cross-linking density, the higher the flexibility and hydration rate, the larger is the surface area of the polymer, and better is the mucoadhesion. Beside chain length and flexibility, the spatial arrangement of the polymer chain is also an important parameter. As for example, despite a high molecular weight of 19,500 kilodaltons for dextran, they have adhesive properties similar to that of PEG with a molecular weight of 200 kilodaltons. The helical conformation of dextran may shield many adhesive active groups primarily responsible for adhesion, unlike PEG polymers which have a linear conformation. The next parameter to discuss is functional groups. Formation of hydrogen bonds between the functional groups of the polymers and mucosal layer also decides the fate of mucoadhesion. Usually, stronger the hydrogen bonding, stronger is the adhesion. The ability of hydroxyl, carboxyl, and amino groups to form strong hydrogen bonds results in improved mucoadhesion owing to presence of these functional groups. Polymers which have the ability to form strong hydrogen bonds include cellulose, starch, acrylic derivatives, and polyvinyl alcohols. The presence of charged functional groups in the polymer chain also has a marked effect on the strength of the mucoadhesion, and anionic polyelectrolytes have been found to form stronger adhesion when compared with neutral polymers. The next important parameter is polymer concentration. The polymer concentration also plays a substantial role in the process of mucoadhesion. At low concentration, there is inadequate and stable interaction between the polymer and the mucosal layer, resulting in weak mucoadhesion. However, for certain polymers like polyvinyl alcohol and polyvinyl pyrrolidone, solvent diffusion into the polymer network decreases at very high polymer concentration due to the formation of highly coiled structure, thereby limiting interpenetration of the polymer and mucin chains with the subsequent reduction in the mucoadhesive property. Apart from the above mentioned physicochemical properties of the polymer, various physiological factors also play an important role in mucoadhesion. As mentioned previously, mucoadhesion is dependent on the ionization of functional groups, which in turn depends upon the pH of the physiological site. Hence, change in the pH may play an important role in tailoring mucoadhesive property. As for example, chitosan, a cationic polyelectrolyte, exhibit profound mucoadhesion in neutral or alkaline medium, but not in acidic conditions. Not only pH, but also other factors such as duration of contact, fluid turnover, hydration, and thickness of mucosal layer plays an important role in governing the mucoadhesive properties of the polymer. The polymers that are commonly employed in the development of mucoadhesive drug delivery system that adhere to mucin epithelial surfaces may be suitably divided into two broad categories. Number one, non-specific or first-generation mucoadhesive polymers. Number two, specific or second-generation mucoadhesive polymers. The non-specific or first-generation mucoadhesive polymers are further classified as anionic polymers, cationic polymers, and non-ionic polymers. First to discuss are anionic polymers. Anionic polymers are widely employed mucoadhesive polymers for drug delivery due to their high mucoadhesive functionality and low toxicity. These polymers are characterized by the presence of sulfate and carboxylic functional groups that give rise to a net overall negative charge at pH values exceeding the pKa of the polymer. Typical examples include polyacrylic acid and its derivatives, polycarbophyll, carbomer, and sodium carboxymethyl cellulose. Polyacrylic acid and sodium carboxymethyl cellulose are hydrophilic in nature and exerts their mucoadhesion by formation of strong hydrogen bonding interactions with mucin. Polyacrylic acid polymers are available in a wide range of molecular weights and are considered safe for oral use by FDA. Polycarbophyll is insoluble in aqueous media but has a high soiling capacity under neutral pH conditions, permitting high levels of entanglement within the mucus layer. Additionally, its non-ionized carboxylic group binds to mucosal surfaces via hydrogen bond interactions. Among presently explored cationic polymer systems, chitosan has gained increasing importance due to its good biocompatibility, biodegradability, and favorable toxicological properties. Whereas anionic polymers binds to mucus via hydrogen bonds, cationic chitosan exhibits its mucoadhesion via ionic interactions between primary amino functional groups and the sialic acid and sulfonic acid substructures of mucus. The linearity of chitosan molecules also ensures sufficient chain flexibility for interpenetration. Chitosan not only provide improved drug delivery via mucoadhesion, it also enhance drug absorption by opening of tight junctions between mucosal cells. Non-ionic polymers such as hydroxypropyl methyl cellulose, methyl cellulose, polyvinyl alcohol, and polyvinyl pyrrolidone also exhibit mucoadhesion. However, their mucoadhesive properties are weak as compared to ionic counterparts, and they have limited use in mucoadhesive drug delivery systems. Next are specific or second-generation mucoadhesive polymers. The major disadvantage of using non-specific mucoadhesive polymers is that adhesion may occur at sites other than those intended. Unlike non-specific polymers, second-generation polymers binds directly to mucosal surfaces, the phenomena termed as cytoadhesives. Further, as surface proteins and carbohydrate composition at target site varies regionally, more accurate drug delivery may be achievable. Examples of this class of polymers include thiolated polymers and lectin-based polymers. Thiolated polymers or thiomers are second-generation mucoadhesive polymers derived from hydrophilic polymers such as polyacrylates, chitosan, or deacetylated gallan gum. The presence of free thiol groups in these polymers help to bind with cysteine-rich subdomains of mucin through formation of disulfide linkages. This results in increased residence time and improved bioavailability. VILS, first generation mucoadhesive platforms, are facilitated via non-covalent secondary interactions. The covalent bonding mechanisms involved in second generation systems lead to interactions that are less susceptible to changes in pH or ionic strength. Examples of thiolated polymers include polyacrylic acid cysteine, polyacrylic acid homocysteine, sodium carboxymethyl cellulose cysteine, chitosan thioglycolic acid, chitosan thioethyl amidine, alginate cysteine, and polymethacrylic acid cysteine. The second polymers under this category is lectin-based polymers. Lectins are proteins found in animals, microorganisms, and plants, which have the ability to reversibly bind with specific carbohydrate or sugar residues. Their specific affinity towards sugar or carbohydrates provide them with specific cytoadhesive property. After initial mucosal cell binding, lectins can either remain on the cell surface or possibly become internalized by a process of endocytosis. Such systems could offer dual functions, including targeted attachment and controlled drug delivery via active cell-mediated drug uptake. Lectins extracted from legumes have been widely explored to develop targeted delivery systems. Lectins extracted from soybean and peanuts have shown specific binding to mucosa. The wheat germ agglutinin has been explored for oral and aerosol delivery system due to its capability to bind to the intestinal and alveolar epithelium. Although lectins offer significant advantage in relation to site targeting, many of them are toxic or immunogenic, and the effects of repeated lectins exposures are largely unknown. It is also feasible that lectin-induced antibodies could block subsequent adhesive interactions between mucosal epithelial cell surface and lectin delivery vehicles. Moreover, such antibodies may also render individuals susceptible to systemic anaphylaxis on subsequent exposure. Most of the currently developed smart polymeric drug delivery systems and their applications have not been made the clinical transition. In such a case, there are some critical points that have to be considered. The most significant one is potential cytotoxicity of smart polymers involved in the delivery of biomolecular drugs such as peptides, proteins, and nucleic acids. Another reason is the response time of the polymer. In majority of cases, it occurs on a reasonably slow time, and therefore fast-acting polymer systems are required. Thermoresponsive polymeric drug delivery systems are well characterized and have proven useful for a wide range of applications. But unfortunately, most commonly used acrylamide or acrylic acid polymers are not hydrolytically degradable and often are associated with neurotoxicity. So these adverse effects limit the field of smart polymeric drug delivery. Higher molecular weight smart polymers are more effective in reaching their cellular targets, but they are not biodegradable and thus are not excreted. So, they tend to accumulate in the body, limiting their clinical trials. Research into smart drug delivery systems is predominantly focused on cancer treatment and has attractive features such as physical or active targeting towards cancer cells and special protection of drugs under circulation. But these do not show any clinical success until the drug delivery system can kill even last cancer cells. Some cancer cells undergo metastasis and are very difficult to kill. This challenging behavior represents a huge barrier to the clinical use of smart polymers. This module details about stimulus-responsive drug delivery systems as well as mucoadhesive and bioadhesive polymers. With the advancement of novel drug delivery systems, smart polymeric drug delivery systems provide a link between therapeutic need and drug delivery. Various stimuli are utilized to attain the controlled and site-specific delivery of drugs. Smart polymeric drug delivery systems have wide applications in the field of oral drug delivery of biological drugs, which are sensitive to both gastric acid and enteric enzymes, and also in the field of smart diagnostics. Inherent limitations of these drug delivery systems are slow response times. While there are many exciting challenges facing this field, there are numerous opportunities for the development of smart polymeric drug delivery systems. Smart polymeric drug delivery systems have a wide range of applications and are likely to have an exciting future. Thanks.